हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर जयश्री, सीनियर ऑब्स्टेट्रिशियन एंड गायनोकोलॉजिस्ट एट अंकुरा हॉस्पिटल्स बंजारा हिल्स। टुडे वील बी टॉकिंग अबाउट ए हाई रिस्क प्रेगनेंसी। व्हाई डू वी कॉल ए हाई रिस्क प्रेगनेंसी? सो दीज आर द फैक्टर्स, इफ दे आर देयर ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी कैन पुट द मदर एंड द डेवलपिंग फीटस आर द बेबी इन टू ए रिस्क। इट कैन कॉज defects or deformities or some problems which can be disable the mother or baby, or morbidity. This is called morbidity, or sometimes leading to death, mortality. Morbidity, mortality significantly increase if they are associated with some factors. These are all the high risk factors. So this is very important to identify a woman where she is when we see her for the first time in pregnancy. We should be able to categorize whether she is in a low risk group or high risk group. So identifying the high risk problems helps us to deal with the pregnancy well. So we can plan a strategy for this woman and we can take her through the pregnancy safely. That is the reason when we get any pregnant lady to us first, we should check and see and categorize them into the low risk or high risk. So there are so many factors we take into consideration. For example, starting from the age of the patient. See, a teenage girl, 16 years, if they conceive, she comes under a high risk category because she can develop pregnancy induced hypertension or many complications during pregnancy. Likewise, pregnancy at age above 35, so they are also run into complications. So starting from the age less than 16, above 35 is a high risk group. Again, likewise, the build of the patient, weight of the patient, underweight, poor nutrition, malnourished patient will not sail through pregnancy safely. She may get into problems, she may have a premature delivery, her baby and she will run into risk of anemia and hypertension, pregnancy induced hypertension during pregnancy. Likewise, overweight patients, they may develop diabetes or hypertension during pregnancy. And likewise, pre-existing diseases in some women. So medical problems which are existing. See, nowadays we see many women coming to us with pre-existing medical problems because they are planning their pregnancies at a later age. By that age, they develop some of the medical problems like hypertension, diabetes, or they may be suffering with some medical problems like epilepsy, fits, asthmatics, some chronic renal diseases or liver disease. Nowadays, with advanced medical facilities available, many of the heart patients, see, they undergo surgeries. Congenital heart problems, if they have, they undergo surgery in young age, and when they become adults, they will be able to conceive. So heart patients with heart diseases, lung diseases, kidney diseases, liver diseases are coming to us with pregnancies. They are all under high risk group. So this is very important to see the patient, examine thoroughly and elicit their history of past diseases, medical problems, and give them a category. Likewise, if we see a pregnant woman already having children, so what about her previous pregnancies? Whether she had any problems during previous pregnancies, whether it is a very uneventful pregnancy where she didn't have any problems, or whether she had miscarriages, whether she had ectopic pregnancy, whether she had a pregnancy which is called molar pregnancy. So all these types of women coming with previous pregnancy history which was led to some complication, they should be treated with care because they may develop similar sort of pregnancy related complications again. Likewise, preeclampsia, that is hypertension during pregnancy. All these problems can recur, and whether she had previously very easy normal delivery or whether she had an instrumental delivery like forceps application or whether they had a cesarean section. So all these factors will give us an indication whether this woman needs special care during pregnancy. They are all come under again high risk group. So likewise, identifying the high risk pregnancy and giving care. See, sometimes they have problems which need a multimodality approach. If a patient comes with a heart disease with pregnancy, then the obstetrician takes care of the pregnancy part of it, and her heart condition has to be reviewed by the cardiologist. Like this, we have to involve other specialties depending on the need. If it's a patient, we had a patient conceived after a renal transplant. These are rare conditions, but that patient needs lot of care during pregnancy. So the nephrologist was taking care of her and obstetrician were taking care of the patient. So throughout pregnancy, she was shuffled between us, obstetrician and nephrologist. So likewise, we are getting now patients conceiving who had medical problems which were like in the previous years were not treated. Now the medical facilities are so much, and advanced medical facilities are giving treatment, and we get patients after renal transplant, after liver diseases treated. So these people are all under high risk. So there are, what you should know is, anybody who is coming to us, that patient should be identified and given, patient should be clearly explained, these are the problems you have. You are having overweight, obesity, or you are having family history. So family history is also important. If the family mother or father is having diabetes or hypertension, the pregnant lady can develop diabetes or hypertension during pregnancy. So we screen, all our pregnant women are screened for diabetes in early pregnancy. Likewise, thyroid disease. So there are some special tests we do in early in pregnancy to identify. So when they come for first antenatal visit, first time when you see the patient, so few tests we do to recognize problems like thyroid. If there is thyroid problem, we should treat. If there is any urinary tract infection, so you're doing urine examination, if there is an infection, the urinary infection has to be treated. Otherwise, this urinary tract infection during pregnancy can cause problems later on, which can infect the kidneys, and it can be a dangerous situation for the women. Likewise, do screening for diabetes. So for everybody, we do a glucose challenge test, where we give them some glucose to drink and test again to see whether she had any tendency to develop diabetes during pregnancy. So in early pregnancy, we do the screening tests and identify the risk factors. Likewise, one side mother and other side baby has to be evaluated. So baby has to be screened, whether baby is doing normally growing or not, whether it is developing any problems. So there are some basic scans which we have to see in pregnancy. Like around 12 weeks, we do a scan. It is called NT scan, where we see whether baby has developed normally or not, whether there are any defects. During that time, we can make out some of the congenital defects developing the nervous system. Likewise, around 20 weeks, there is another scan. It's a organ scan. It is called TFA scan. So we have to see whether baby is doing well or not, whether all organs are developed properly or not. So these are important milestones during pregnancy which should not be missed. Many times we get patients after third month, after crossing the NT scan time. So we miss some of the problems which we could have diagnosed otherwise. There is a tendency for women and the elderly people, at women, there is no need to go for checkup now, you can go after third month. So still we see people coming, pregnant women coming after third month. So please try to understand, when you conceive, you should always come to the patient, the gynecologist, immediately for your first visit, where we can identify if there are any risk factors and screen you properly and give you the, whether you come under low risk or high risk, whether you need special attention, all that information can be passed on in the first antenatal visit. So it is very important to consult a doctor as soon as you conceive.